I have a few confessions that I think I ought to make, and I'll try to break them tenderly for everybody's sake. The first about my laundress, who has left this world of strife. If you'll listen, I will tell you how she came to lose her life. I murdered her last Tuesday, but I thought it would be best. And never, never more will she tear buttons from my vest. And now I'll get my Sunday shirt and collars in one piece. For I murdered her last Tuesday. It was a merciful relief. There used to be an organ man who played along our street. But now he'll never play again. His heart has ceased to beat. I tallied off one evening when the light was getting dim. And I pulled out my revolver and I pointed it at him. I murdered him, that organ man. I don't think I was wrong. He wasn't wanted in this world. He'd been here far too long. Was it Saturday or Friday now? I can't remember which. But at any rate, I murdered him without the slightest hint. Poor fella. A terrible misfortune has befallen our family. My wife's poor mother has gone off into eternity. She used to give me lectures, but she won't do that again. She said my conduct pained her, so I put her out of pain. It was on a summer's morning that the dreadful deed was done. No fuss or talk about it, just a bullet from a gun. She never seemed contented, and I thought it time she went. So I murdered her one morning. It was very kindly meant. Another notoriety has left this world full speed. And once again I take the blame. Was I who did the deed? It's my caddy I'm referring to. A most obnoxious lad. If I'd let him live much longer, I'd have soon gone raving mad. So I flew him in a bunker. It was Wednesday of last week. I approached him with my matches, and I finished with the cleat. And nevermore my slicing or my pulling will he guide. For I murdered him in bogey, and he had a lovely life. Take me away, constable. I am quite ready.